Hey, what's going on? My name is Christian from BitBranding, and today we're going to tackle how to choose the correct theme for your Shopify store. Let's do this. So on my Shopify dashboard, I'm going to go ahead and click on online store. Right here under themes, I'm going to go ahead and click on visit the theme store. And right here on the theme store, you'll see that they have collections, and they'll show you some of the trending that are trending this week. You will see different categories that they have created as far as big, beautiful imagery, grid style layout, etc. But this doesn't really tell you that much. Maybe under industries, maybe your company or your store falls under one of these industries, and that helps you a little bit better. But I'm gonna go ahead and click on all themes, because I do think that maybe every industry has the opportunity to not necessarily be boxed within what they share as far as the industry. So right here, this is what's gonna be very powerful for you. I would definitely spend some money on some of the paid themes, but I'm not saying that you have to have a paid theme in order to have something that looks great. There's a few of the free themes that will probably do the job that you're looking for. But when it comes to picking the right or the correct theme for your store, these are the things that I would definitely look into. The number of products on your store is something very important. So single product, small catalogs, medium, large. I would highly pay attention to this setting right here as far as the amount of products that you have. When it comes to layout style, it doesn't really matter. It's more of a personal preference. But then here's where it gets a little bit more interesting, because you will see more of the features that each of these themes have. So each theme they're created by different companies. So they all include different things as far as features within those themes. So if it's important for you that for example, product page has image zoom, then you wanna make sure that you hit that check mark right there. You wanna make sure that your homepage actually has a slideshow, that you wanna click on that. And the reason why I say that these features are very important is because once you install this theme and you start customizing that theme, and then down the road you realize, oh, I really wanted something that had a size chart, but you didn't click on the little check mark for the size chart. So your theme, the people who created that theme, might not have added that feature into that. So it's gonna be a lot harder. You're gonna have to hire a developer to include certain features that you wanted that you didn't have before. So I would definitely pay close attention to these features and make sure that you know exactly what you want feature-wise on your theme, because otherwise down the road, it's gonna be a lot harder to add. Now, I'm gonna show you a little trick, and a lot of people actually don't know this, but if you go to the actual theme, you can do two things here, actually three. You can try it, you can view the demo, or you can buy the theme. Now, a lot of these themes range around the 180, 140 price line. You can do view the demo, and that will just show you the example that they have here. So you'll be able to see at a glance all the things that you can do. But what I would definitely recommend is clicking on try theme. Is actually going to go ahead and add this to my store, and we'll be able to see a sort of a live preview of how the theme looks. So you see, once that's uploaded and ready to go, you'll be able to sort of see your store with that new theme. Now, because this is a brand new theme, completely different than what I currently have right now, what I currently have published, a lot of these sections are going to be empty. Right? So this featured collection is empty. There's no products, there's no images, there's no nothing. So in order to truly appreciate this theme and be able to tell that this is gonna be the one for me, I would highly, highly suggest that you click on that customize theme. When you click on that customize theme, you will be able to essentially build this however you want and have an idea on how it will look before even purchasing the full theme. So before knowing that this is gonna be the one for me, I can actually go in here and look at all these sections and change maybe the heading. So little bits, streets. And it will live change, it will make the changes live on the website. So again, you will be able to see exactly how your website will look before even paying a single penny to any of these, for any of these themes. Now you can hit save all you want on these, but you might think that the content is gone once you exit out of this. I'm gonna show you here, when it comes to Shopify, again, it's all about those different themes. So right now I have my venture theme. That's the current live theme. But if we see down here under theme library, we have the debut, which is the one that comes automatically with it. I have this broadcast that I was actually also doing the same thing, just trying this that theme. And then we have the streamline, which is the one that we just saved just now. And again, right now, if you go look at my website, you will see that this is still the theme that is active. That's because this is my live theme currently. But that trial theme is right here. And again, if I click customize, I'll be able to go back to that page and keep adding things to that theme before purchasing. Once you're ready to purchase, you can do the drop down here. You can purchase the theme. And then once you purchase it, then you can make it live and it will look something like this. When you click on the drop down, you will be able to hit publish. Once you hit publish, that will become your new live theme. All right, that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this episode where we covered how to choose the correct theme, make sure that you hit that subscribe, a thumbs up, and leave a comment down below and let us know, what do you want to learn next on Shopify?